Hello everyone, my name is Frank Schlichting. I'd like to welcome you to Grand Forks and a brand new season of Wings Over Canada. I want to show you some really stunning photography. We can get to some really interesting places. We're going to mount a bunch of cameras on this plane. The other thing that's really exciting is light sport aircraft. Aircraft such as this one here is built basically out of, this is all aluminum here. These wings are aluminum. The rest of the aircraft is built out of a composite type of a fiberglass material. This aircraft weighs about 672 pounds, somewhere in there, so it's quite light. And yet you can carry two people in it, about 4 hours of fuel. And the performance is quite good. It flies along 120 miles an hour, 120 miles an hour, somewhere in there, cruising speed. Quite economical to operate. This aircraft has got 100 horsepower Rotax in it. It burns about 15 liters of regular gasoline or less per hour, depending on how fast you're going. So the cost of ownership is somewhere around $25 an hour actually to fly this, including fuel. So, you know, pretty comparable to other type of sports, whether, you know, be skidooing or classic cars or other things that people have. But jump in the plane there, do up your seatbelts, and we'll take you for a ride.
I wish that I could fly into the aircraft that we're flying in today is a 2006 Allegro. I purchased it from Montreal last April and flew it across Canada shortly after that. And this July, I flew this plane up to Tuktoyaktuk, to the Arctic Ocean there, and had a pretty nice trip up there. Took a week or so from Grand Forks. So we've got about 170 hours I've flown in it in the last 8 months or so. And we're having lots of fun with this plane. In coming episodes, we'll be visiting other pilots, and they can tell us about their planes and what they like about them. Go do some flying with them. Lots of other real cool places in BC to check out. Beautiful scenery here, and we invite you to come along with us. So we've got a bunch more clips we're going to show you, and we'll do a little bit more flying. Oh.
trailer, not the early one that you wish upon, not the northern one, the gods and the sailors. You've got that touch so gentle and sweet, but you've got that look so critical. Can't talk to you, babe, you know I get so weak. Sometimes I think that love is just mythical. Up there's a heaven, down there's a town. Blackness everywhere, a little light shine. Blackness, blackness, dragging me down. Come on out again, in this heart of mine.
You've enjoyed some of the places that we went to, some of the mines and towns we've flown over, just to give you kind of a bit of an idea what we can do with these cameras. The camera that I'm actually using to film all this is about a $150 camera, so you know, in the coming episodes if we get some better cameras, there's an Aviation type GoPro that has better has gyros in it, so it's much steadier, and that also has a filter for propellers, so you don't see the propeller in it. So quite amazing little cameras what they can do. The one thing that's been pretty exciting is the explosion of these light sport aircraft. This aircraft is a lot cheaper to fly than a conventional aircraft, and yet it still has the same performance that is a 172 or a 150 Cessna that a lot of people are familiar with. The one reason it's quite economical is because this aircraft's quite light. Even though it'll fly at 100 to 120 miles an hour and carry two passengers, has good performance. I can climb by myself, it'll climb about 1400 feet a minute. Range is pretty fair, can fly for about 4 hours or so at 100 miles an hour. That gives you 400 mile range or so with a bit of a prudent reserve. So this aircraft only weighs 672 pounds because it's got all aluminum. The wings are aluminum and the rest of the aircraft is made out of composite. And that's quite smooth, as you can see. So it doesn't take so much power to fly it through the sky. The motor in this aircraft is 100 horsepower Rotex, and it runs on regular car gas, so that's a very bit cheaper than aviation fuel. Car gas is, it does need premiums, so it, you know, it's about $1.25 a liter versus up to $2 a liter for aviation fuel. So, well, I hope you've enjoyed the trip, and we'll see you next time on Wings Over Canada.